systems, and people's actions will mean something in it. And that's a very, very important part of the 11th pillar. And the last one, we go for, of course, is server meshing. So when we get server meshing, that is, we think, the last piece of the puzzle to have the full game experience. And this is our ability to go, you know, right now we have about 50 players on the server. We probably will be able to increase that number because of bandwidth and stuff. But it's still going to cap out at some level. With server meshing, we'll be able to get to thousands of players playing concurrently in the same location, star systems. They're not all going to be able to have 1,000 people talk about it together. They won't be able to render it all at the same time. But you certainly will be able to have, you know, 1,000 people on the planet person, for instance. So the server meshing is the last key piece, because that will allow us to have a truly massively populated universe of players as well as AI, and having the servers that dynamically scale up and down to take care of the processing needs of that. So from our standpoint, in terms of what we would think is the experience when you guys can sit in and play the game day after day and not worry about it getting wiped, not worrying about, oh, I'm going to do something for day two and at some point we're going to reset the system. When we get to full systems and server meshing, that's our marker. And sure, after that, we've got planets to do and star systems, and we're going to have continual feature development. But this is an online, live game. And so for us, we don't have a particular viewpoint in terms of, oh, that's it, this is where we finish it, and we don't do any more work. It's like literally our kind of view, as long as you guys want to live in this universe, every 3 months, we're giving you a build. Here you are, and here's a bit more, and here's a bit more, here's a bit more. And when we get to the full persistence of server meshing, I think at that point, that's when we're not going to be resetting the servers. It's when it will be an ongoing, living, streaming game. And that, I'm not going to give you a date, but... Those are what we view as our, you know, sort of cornerstones that we need to get to. And yes, there's a lot of other things that we talked about that we're also working on. But when we get that, we feel like it will be a game like that. So that is kind of what we, in terms of road to release. But speaking of near-term release, 3.3, I think we're going to go wide to... first, and then as long as things don't blow up too badly, then we're going to go full wide, and then we're going to keep hammering on it, because we want to get 3.3 in everyone's hands as soon as possible, because object constraint and streaming and bank pulling makes a massive difference to the experience and performance. And once we get that stable, we need a lot of people playing and testing it, because that helps us with chasing down all these sort of edge cases that are very hard to replicate. Then we're going to roll in the custom local aspect, which we showed earlier today, and I think it should be a pretty great patch when all that's said and done. And there's a lot of stuff in 3.3, I think we talked about it, but quite a lot of new ships. I mean, I think it's probably one of our, and it's kind of fun, it's the first one, we have a straight to fly up the ship, the Valkyrie, which is cool. I think the Hammerheads are probably the biggest ship that we've got in the game at the moment. It's probably got the first firepower of the ship in the game. And you've got, you know, the Phoenix, which is great firepower and luxury, and the cool new Mustang, and all the Tumbril variants are really cool too. So I think it's going to be cool. I'm looking forward to you guys playing it. So that's that. If we just go forward, one extra thing we're going to do. And I don't think any other company that operates an online game does this, or I'm not aware of someone does this. But we collect telemetry on, obviously, all the servers and all the plants that are connected to us. And so we get a good idea of what the frame rates are, what the machine specs are, what the latency is, what the load times are. And we've often had debates, because we see a lot of anecdotal, So everybody came in class, and we're like, we're watching the data, and that's not exactly what our data says. So we decided that we wanted to give all you guys the ability to track the telemetry yourselves. So what we have is you can go into the website, this will release in 3.3, and we will have live telemetry on 3.3 going forward. You'll be able to see your machine, so where you start in the CPU score, where you sit in the GPU, it will tell you what your stats are. And we're going to be tracking, not all the stuff gets tracked right away, but we're planning on tracking the latency and the loading times to see the crashes, and then you can track yourself against the heat map of everybody playing the game and see where you land. And see also the kind of specs are. In the spirit of open development, you guys are seeing what we see in our control dashboard, and you can also sort of see, because PCs are challenging because everybody has a slightly different configuration, and you don't know if someone's Bitcoin mining on the side or trying to do something, or doing nothing, right? But it's quite interesting, and I have to say that there's we've had a few outliers on this where some people have had like thread rippers that are just crushing it. 3.3. So it's pretty interesting that the new Intel multi-core ones are doing pretty awesome too. So you guys will be able to track yourself against everyone else, and then longer term, not right away, but I think the next stage is we'll open this up so you can sort of see our server performance too. So you'll be able to track how the servers are doing, what the stability is, what their frame rates are. So you know, when everyone's debating, it sucks or whatever, you just go to this page and see how it goes. So I think that should be. There's a lot of stuff we're developing specifically that goes into the squadron and then goes across into the GU. We're closing it down. All the remaining features were in content. And the last major technical hurdle that we were worried about in the squadron was object container streaming, which, as you know, we're almost ready to close out here on 3.3. So we don't have any major technical hurdles left on squadron. So for us, it's a bit easier to get Squadron closed out and obviously start sitting in these server meshing for the rest of them. So that's right, we're going to publish the public roadmap for you guys in December, all the way to completion of the project. And I'm just going to leave you with something right now.
Thank you.
2022. Play it again.
Thank you.
thank you to all you guys, because you guys make all of this possible. And you're a big player here, and you can come back here. Outside, right? Drinks, fun, and a quiz.